Back with another tutorial. This time I want to show you how you can use Ladybug to create an interactive sunlight system to make shadow studies on your model, and how you can control the Rhino sunlight from within Grasshopper. And I will also show you how you can then later animate the sunlight. For that we will again use weather data to define the location. So we use a real location to get a very precise idea of the shadow situation on a model. Apologize for my model, I created a collection of boxes which slightly reminds of a I don't know, town center, but it doesn't really matter. It's about how to create this sunlight system. So at the moment it's just the normal Rhino sunlight. So if we would go in here, you could see I can turn this on and off. If you don't use any materials, then at least give your model a bit of just some kind of gray material. Otherwise it will look very blown out. And I'm using the rendered viewport with shadows on and surface edges. Okay, let's jump right in. In Grasshopper we will, as usual, create our Ladybug setup. This is always the ladybug tool, as we already discussed. Then we need the weather data, which we download here. I build these things every time from scratch for you, so you can follow along. Opa, that was not the right thing. So go here. And it's good to repeat these things because it becomes like a brain muscle memory. We need this one. We actually don't need this one, but I show you that you can use this component as well. What else? We need this one. Basically, we get the weather data here from the website. Click that, we jump to the website. Let's just choose maybe Japan this time. Matsumoto. Okay. We click on copy link to clipboard. You can also download the weather file, but I prefer this method. We get a panel. Where we paste what we just copied. Okay, don't click enter, just click OK. We put this to the weather file URL. That will take a while just to load. And then we can, so in order to control the sunlight, we have this component here in the environmental analysis, which we will discuss more in detail in the next video. But so just to get started with a very simple and easy to understand tool, this is the Ladybug set Rhino sunlight, and this is really handy. So as you can see, it already changed something here. What kind of input does it need? It needs a location, it needs the north, which we discussed. Normally if the model is already in the correct north rotation, then you don't need to place anything here. Otherwise you would provide a line. Maybe I can show that. If let's say this is my north, I could use that as my alternative north direction with a line or curve component. So put this in here and then set one line. Select, and then we have a north, but I will leave that for now. You don't need that. Okay, it needs a location. The location can be extracted from the weather file, and the import E plus weather file component actually has this slot here called location. If we connect this, then and we check what's in here with the panel again, And we see, okay, the site location is Matsumoto, Japan. The coordinates for latitude and longitude, this time zone and the elevation even, which also has an influence on how the sunlight interacts with the building. That would just go in here, connect. Now you could argue that for such a small use of this whole thing here, would it not be better to kind of extract that in a different way? Actually, there is another component for that in Ladybug, which is called Ladybug import location, and that just gets the location from the weather file, and that's what we're gonna use. This is only to just simplify and to keep this whole script a bit more tied up. Now we can define the month with a slider, number slider. Put this to 1. Oh, it's, of course it has none. We don't have 24 months. Idiotic. What also nice is that it always copies the name of the variable into the name of the slider, whatever. It's day 24, ah, sorry, 31. I'm already thinking about the hours, not about the day. So this is from 1 to 31. Copy. And the hour would be 0 to 24, and we need a toggle, so we can just put this to false and copy. Okay, it all looks good. Now we only need to run it. Now of course it's in the night, so you won't see anything here. Let's choose maybe March, mid-March, and maybe let's do 3 o'clock in the afternoon. And yeah, here you have it. This is now of course a fictional kind of town center or city district in Matsumoto, but you can see that this, yeah, it's quite it gives you a very instant idea. For example, if you would like to know to which time you have sunlight at a certain point within this road, then you can check that. And you can just basically use the slider to go through. So this is super handy. Today you can actually see how this is changing over the month, the shadow. Let's try another month, maybe June, and okay, the evening. So here you could say which areas are, or which facade sides are exposed to the evening sunlight. So yeah, this, so you see, is actually quite simple to set this up. And now when you animate when you want to animate this, let's say you want to animate one day, then it has this, I mean, you can animate a lot actually in Grasshopper, especially with these number sliders. You just click here and press animate, and it will give you Yeah. So it asks you for a folder to save. And then you can actually, so you can define the resolution. That's, of course, too big for me. I don't need that. I used HD resolution, and then the frame count. But the problem now is that, let's cancel this, that currently the hour would only, this slider would only jump from 1 hour to the next. So I can actually increase this by introducing a floating point number. And reduce this here to 1. And then I also want to, for that specific day, I want to restrict my slider to the time where there's actually light. In that case, it would be, you can see there is some light coming up already around 3 o'clock. So you can see here it's getting bluish. So let's say 3.5. Oh, sorry. So I need to restrict that here to 3.5. Okay, and then in the evening it would be somewhere around 6 p.m. Okay, now when I animate, I get for each hour 10 slides. Maybe let's try to find a nice camera angle. Yeah, and then we click animate. And then frame count. So I just calculate this quickly. So from 3.5, from 3:30 to 6 in the evening. So that's 6 in the evening minus 145 frames. Let's see how that would work. 145. Okay. Now it's just printing all these frames. So we can actually have a look in our folder. Great, so this was finished. Now you would just need a software which you can just stitch these things together. I would normally use Blender. And in Blender is free, by the way, if you looking for a free video editor. It's not really a video editor, but I mean, it is also a video editor, but it's also an incredible, amazing 3D animation tool, 3D modeling, rendering, whatever you want. So here I would just go in video editing and select add image sequence, go into my Rhino folder, and select my image sequence. Not sure why it's doing this. It's because it's transparent. Wait, let's see. What if I do this? Yeah, that was the problem. Yeah, we have a really cool shadow animation. Yeah, stupid me here. I was like moving the mouse. I was zooming out during the export. Okay. But I hope you will forgive me about this. So, there's one more thing I want to show. Back to Rhino. A very cool feature here is if you want to use it more as an interactive tool and you want to like play around, check your streets if they have sunlight or not, or at which time, and you don't want to always have this grasshopper open, you can also get this into here. So how does it work? Yeah, so there's this option where you can publish to remote panel. And now you should actually be able to see it, yeah. So publish to remote panel, and then now I can play with my animation in here and don't need to open the grasshopper window. That's it for today. I hope you like it. Hit the bell button and subscribe. Thanks, guys.